Welcome, Procast Creators. Today we are making a cushion for a bench. As you can see, these are some of the items that you would need: a piece of wood, some foam, scissors, everything that's there, along with some adhesive spray and a pneumatic stapler, which are not pictured. I bought a piece of wood from Home Depot to the size that I needed. And then I had some foam at home. And as you can see, my foam is a little short compared to my wood. So I decided that I was not spending $49 a yard. I was going to use what I had at home. So that's why you see that I am trying to add another piece there. So I am cutting that piece to size and measuring it up and trying to figure out exactly where I need to cut. And with the knife, the kitchen knife that I had, I started to cut that piece to the size that fit the missing piece for the wood. So as you can see, I'm making those cuts there because I, like I said, was being a little too cheap. So cock my leg up there and get to work with what I have. Y'all like my little pigs on my LaRuru pants? Is that who they are? Anyways, I think they're cute, but I, you know, anyways, okay. So stay on track. All right. So now after I finish cutting my piece of foam, I get my adhesive spray and I try to connect the two pieces together. At first, that did not work, y'all. Okay. So what I eventually decided that I was going to do after I tried this, trying to press the two pieces together, I decided I was just going to spray the board and then add the foam to the board. And as you can see, the glue got really tacky. I have batten and foam all over my nails right now. So I'm not too happy about that. Might have to go to the shop and get them redone now. But anyway, so I'm spraying the adhesive on the board, and then eventually I'm going to connect both pieces to the board. So you see that there, where I'm connecting that final piece or attaching that final piece after I spray the board with the adhesive spray. So now that that is complete, and I have again still started to press those two pieces together, and you can see it's white from all the adhesive on the creases of that. So once that was done, the next thing that I did was lay down my material, laid a piece of batting on top of that, and then I took my board and put my board with the foam connected to it on top of that piece of batting and the material. From that point, I just wanted to make sure that I had enough material and batting on each side so that one side wouldn't be shorter than the other, or that one side wouldn't go around. I then used my pneumatic stapler to staple down the sides, put a couple of staples on each side before I truly tacked it all the way down. And it's a good thing that I did because I was pulling so tightly. As you can see there, I was pulling pretty tight because I thought I wanted it tight. But then as I turned the board over, it was a little too tight, which you'll see in a few moments. But as you can see right now, I'm just kind of putting a few tacks in there just so that I can make sure the material stays in place and that it looks the way that I want it to look when I turn it over. But again, I am pulling kind of tight. So in the jobs that I've done before this one, that it all needed to be pulled tight, but I guess you gotta figure out that balance. So again, I'm learning this process, so that's one of the things that I am figuring out is when and how to pull the material. So as you can see, it's really tight and strained, so I actually popped one of the staples back out that was holding it, redid that, as you can see right there. I think I'm getting ready to redo that staple, and from there then staple the rest of the material on. From that point, I took the sides and did them like I would wrap a present. And so you see I'm folding it over, and I'm gonna staple those pieces down. So I'm doing that now, and I put a couple of staples in there, and I'm gonna do this to every corner. I'm only gonna show you this corner. My camera angle wasn't the best with this one. So then I fold that piece over, making sure my corners are neat and that they look good. And again, that it's not too tight. And once I get it to where I think it looks good, I go ahead and put some staples in that. And then, like I said, I do it to the other three sides of the board, completing the task. And then, as you can see, this is what the cushion ultimately looked like. And even though I'm not finished my bench with the painting and stuff, I just wanted to show you what it's going to look like inside the bench.